Just a little bit about Art Klub. We also have Dancing Grounds, Dance for Social Change. They have a Dance for Social Change festival happening this weekend, and we have their youth program with a show tomorrow. They did a show today at 3. Their final performance is tomorrow at 3. It's called The Unions. So come out and see that tomorrow at 3. Also, one of Artivism's company members, Elsie Jones, has a new company called Elevate, and she has a show coming up in April. So please come out and see her. Quick thing about the art exhibition here, we do all sorts of different kinds of programming. We do dance and theater and visual art and film and public events and, you know, all sorts of stuff, kids programming. So our visual arts exhibition was inspired for International Women's Day, which we elongated into, what is it? It's Women's History Month. Yeah. Thank you. And it's called the Womb Room. Thank you. And more information about the artists that are exhibiting are in a folder up there, and you can ask me if you have any questions about any of the artwork. And all of that can be found on our website, artclub.org. Social media is artclubnola. Sign our email list up there. If you sign up, it's both Artivism and Art Klub. We share. One thing I would like to announce, we haven't officially announced it yet, is that Sophia Rabinovitz, who is the Artivism director. Artistic director, is now our Art Klub's associate director. Mm-hmm. Yes! So she will be taking over, God willing, everything. Okay, not everything, I promise. We'll throw you up the ladder. So enough about that. We're here for Artivism. Thank you for coming. Artivism Dance Theater. A little bit about them. They are starting back up their dance classes on Sundays. They're going to start them back up on Sundays at 2 o'clock. It's a different teacher every week with a different discipline. The teachers are the Artivism company members. And you can find out all about their programming also on their social media, which is Artivism Dance. One last thing, after the show, we're going to take a little 5-minute break where you can grab another drink, go to the potty, and then we're going to do a Q&A if you'd like to stay. We'll go mingle, then come back up here for the Q&A. Bathrooms are there, handicap accessible is on the right in the back, and emergency exits if we end up having to make a hasty exit, which we're not, but if that happens, there's one there, and there, and out on the sides. That's enough. Okay. Enjoy the show! Thank you.
No, I do agree with you, and I think it's less about having the information and more about it being taboo to talk about.
Yeah.
That you don't know how people might react. You don't know
right.
what's appropriate to say, so nobody talks about it. But then no one talking about it makes it feel like it's not normal.
The Urban Dictionary defines I'm fine as the most told lie in the English language, next to I have read and agreed to the terms and conditions.
Are you okay?
I'm fine.
Are you sure? You seem kind of strange.
I'm fine.
Or I'm fine, something you say to someone when you are not, in fact, fine at all.
Hey, are you doing okay?
I'm fine.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Okay, so you want to go to the party?
Okay.
Okay.
Or, I'm fine. what you say every day to hide the fact that you're not.
Why won't you talk to me?
There's nothing to talk about. I'm fine.
There's obviously so much to talk about.
Sitting all alone, mouth full of gum in the driveway. My friends aren't far in the back of my car. Lay their bodies. Who is my mind? Who is my mind?
Still adulting, like, to this day.
Yeah, it's sure.
Well, look, I lie to myself every day and tell myself I'm an adult. Like, I got it all together. You know, you post your cute pics on social media. You gotta wake up every morning. You gotta cook for yourself. So hard. I mean, I know, it's a lot. But that's okay. But you know, You wouldn't know that if you looked at my Instagram, duh, hey. Matter of fact, let's take a selfie. Hello.
Hi.
This is my camera. Hashtag Artivism 2019. Hello, can I take a picture with you? Hello. Yes, the elephant. Get your tickets. We have one more show tomorrow, okay? Let's see, because that don't look right. I need a filter. That's better. Ooh. What is happening? This social media thing is taking over. Like, it's going a little overboard, don't you think? Let me tell y'all what I see when I scroll down my feed. It's like this girl with her face beat at the gym. You're supposed to be getting your workout on, sis. How your face beat at the gym? Let me know. And don't get me started on my pregnant ladies, you know, snatched in their photos with their newborn in their hand. How? Teach me. And don't get me started on the hashtags. I mean, hashtag self-care. Hashtag living my best life. What is even living my best life? We're like three. How do you know how to live your best life already? Teach me, for real. But, you know, there's always that moment or that one relationship that we keep going back to just because that's all we know. Or that one mother who has to get food on the table for her children because that's what they're expecting. Life is hard and it's a lot. But that's okay, because we're here to talk about it, because that's why you came, right? Mm-hmm. To talk about these things. Well, let me tell y'all. So, you know that one person who's just always asking you for something, whether it's food or money, and you're gonna give it to them, because that's your, like, I'm gonna give it to you, you know? Because that's just who I am. But why now do I feel like I'm receiving nothing in return?
Just like a big forest. He said he never met a girl who makes
for, Jenna? What you want me for? What you want
Tell
me
what
for?
You want.
What you want me for? What you waiting for then?
Success in dealing with your trauma and living with it is not that it never actually goes away. It's just that you learn how to live with it. We'll be right back. choose to be uncomfortable. And just like anything else, whether, you know, you want to get stronger, so you have to exercise, like, in order to be more mentally healthy, like, you have to work on yourself.
There's no room to be unsure. There's no room to be unsure. For the longest, I couldn't get the words out. There's no room to be unsure. They sat there like lead, heavy in my mouth. Too heavy to be lifted by my vocal cords into the abyss, the potential judgment, the uncertainty of things taboo. Life is messy. Life is complicated. Everything is gray, but we talk as if it's all black or white, yes or no, right or wrong. Just no room to be unsure.
Number 84, the doctor will see you now.
We might be pregnant. That's exciting.
Yeah.
Okay, well, your pee is still percolating, so I'll be right back.
Okay.
Hi. I see it's your first time. Nothing to fear. I need you to scoot on down. Scoot down. Scoot down. Scoot down. Scoot. 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 Okay. Oh, crap. Was it 1:04 already? I'll be right back. Hang tight.
Wait.
Hi. How can
Hi.
I help you?
Yeah, so I'm having a little bit of trouble getting pregnant,
mm-hmm.
and I was wondering if you have any natural recommendations?
No. Is it 1:05? I'm so sorry. I'll be right back. Oh, my God. Okay, so I have a few questions for you. What was the first day of your last period?
12.
Oh, of?
March.
That's my birthday! Okay, so, all right, 12 minus 72 divided by 4, carry the 9, figure out the full moon factor, and divide by pi. Do you have an app?
No.
Oh, those apps are so great. They have one with hearts and rainbows and unicorns and stars and yellow clovers and all the things all women love.
Okay.
Okay, so you should get one of those apps, and I'll be right back. All right, my dear, we're almost ready to start that exam. So let me just take a little look-see here, and whoa, is that normal? Okay, I'm gonna need a few other tools. You hang tight, I'll be right back. Okay, I have something great for you.
Okay.
It's a drug called Clomid. It helps you ovulate. I'm gonna write a little script.
Okay, wait, but what does it do?
It helps you ovulate. Like I said.
Okay.
So, here's that script.
Okay.
And, oh, you know what? I have a few samples for you. I can be right back. I'm gonna grab those.
Oh.
Hang tight.
Okay.
Okay, so, did you download the app?
Yeah.
Ooh, what does it say? Are we pregnant?
I don't know. That's why I came here.
Well, how am I supposed to know? school. Your PE's not ready. It's just not ready yet. I'm really sorry. It's going to take another 2 weeks, okay? Okay, great. I'll see you in 2 weeks. I'm sure it'll be ready by then.
All right. Here we go. Little goggles and... All right. Here we are. You're going to feel a little pinch and...
All right.
A little tilted uterus, but great mucus, though. That's really good. Okay, I'm going to take a little scrape here, a little scrape there. I've got this sample, and if nothing is wrong, you won't hear from me for a whole year. Sound good? Great. Get dressed. Have a great day. All right, so I've got these samples for you.
Okay. Are there any side effects of this medication?
Oh, you know, everyone asks me that. There's really nothing to fear. You might get a little... and then just possibly a little and on a very, very rare occasion, you might end up... but it'll be great. Oh. And hopefully I'll see you in about 3 months.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay.
Have a great day.
All right.
Okay.
Okay.
And my mom was like, oh, wait, this. And I was just like, that's it? You know, like, I was just like, oh, okay, this can't be right. But like, you know, any better. And now maybe I would be like, oh, it's like 11. I haven't really gotten my theory yet. If someone had listened to me, or just backwards when they had to themselves, or something that I had shoes, I was going to watch me and be going, what does this mean? But I don't think that we should be specific to sexual health, or mental health, and I don't think that being embarrassed of that should be as healthy as we can society. I think that we need to educate each other and be able to talk to each other about it.
I feel like there's something's really going on down there.
Finger pull the trigger when I simmer in the sun. Tell my lady I've been with her when the summer's coming gone. You are the moon on the rise, you are my tide, you are the one. Sing the song of creation, an anthem for the young. My next life. Could I take another turn? Live the life I know I. Dove cries, stars shine, and I fly through the night. with my sights set on the next bet. My life is not set yet. I got no regrets, cause to get there, I could I take another turn? Could I burn another day? Could I move like a prince, slay the dragons in my way? I'll be dancing in the wilderness till my dying day. I'll be dancing on the grave of the brave I have slain. Next life. Surrender. Surrender my vision to your glory. It's the story of a silent sky and ancient eyes. New baby blues and the old brown horizon. I surrender to your glory.
Thank you.
up, and if they were alive, he'd throw them back in because starfish can't live outside the water or whatever. And someone went up to him and was like, well, you know you're not going to get to all of these starfish. Like, you're not going to save them all. And he goes, yeah, but I'm going to save this one, and I'm going to save this one. Like, and he saved one of them one at a time.
Thank you. Good.